and Zero's attacked that base. He stepped out of his guard shack, drew his 45 caliber pistol, and began firing on the Japanese Zeros. One of the Japanese pilots, Yoshio Shiga, saw Thompson firing back at him. And years later, he remembered Thompson's tenacity and fighting spirit. Shiga described the Lone Marine as the bravest American I've ever seen. All over the island, soldiers were bringing their weapons to bear in the fight. Anything they could get working. Their 45 caliber pistols, their Springfield rifles. In some cases, our soldiers were able to get the 30 caliber and 50 caliber belt-fed machine guns into action, bringing down numerous marauding Japanese Zeros, Vals, and Kates. But their numbers were overwhelming. 189 in the first flight, 171 in the second flight, a total of 360. Meanwhile, at Bellows Field on the northeast coast of the island, more U.S. Army Air Corps pilots were racing to their P-40s. Just then, Japanese Zeros appeared and started strafing runs. One P-40 pilot was killed just as he stepped into his cockpit. Two other P-40s were down just as they got off the ground. Yes, you see the Curtiss B-40 Warhawk right behind the Japanese Zero, simulating the few planes that were able to get into the air that infamous day. The Kate torpedo bomb is coming in from the left again. The Val dive bomber, the Zeros, doing their strafing runs. This is it. Tora, the surprise Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor, and we've taken you back to that fateful day. The flight of B-17, 16 of them coming from the mainland, arrive and are immediately attacked by the Japanese Zeros. In the confusion, the B-17s were shot at by foe and friend, and the frightened crews landed wherever they could, one in a pineapple field not far from Hickam Field. And you're witnessing a reenactment at that very day, December 7th of 1941. The attack started at 7:55 a.m. As you listen to the air raid sirens, the sound of machine gun fire, the roar of the engine, and the sound of bombs going off, you can just imagine what it must have been like. You thought it was going to be an easy Sunday in the beautiful and serene Hawaiian Islands. And in turn, it turned out to be something quite different. The surprise Japanese attack. And we've taken you back to that fateful day. Watch. Listen to the sound of the engines, the roar of those radial engines. Radial engines on all of the Japanese aircraft. A radial engine on the Curtiss P-36 Hawk. The inline engine of the Curtiss P-40 Warhawk. And you can just imagine the turmoil and the terror